Hi everybody, I am Saeed and you are watching The Key Channel. A few months ago, I have uploaded a couple of videos about installation of HP Laserjet 1010 printer on Windows 10 and Windows 11. Apparently, it is quite impossible. If you visit HP website, you will soon understand that latest available driver for this printer is related to Windows Vista. Do you even remember Windows Vista? It is really old. On those videos, I have provided a solution for this problem using which you can really install this printer on Windows 10 and Windows 11. To our surprise, my video editor and I, thousands of people around the world started watching those videos. It clearly showed that there are thousands of these printers that are still functional. And also, thousands of people are still searching for a way to install it on Windows 10 and Windows 11. The reason is very clear. This type of printer is just middle-aged. It can work for you for several more years. These are heavy-duty office printers. Now that you have installed your printer on Windows 10 or Windows 11, this is a good time to know slightly more about it.
What do you know about these buttons? If you press this one just once, your printer will give you a demo page. A demo page shows you whether or not your printer works smoothly. And then you can press it and hold for 5 seconds. Then it gives you an information page. This is a configuration page. With some information about your printer. One of them is very important, especially for me. Total pages printed. More than 25,000 pages until now. But did you know that these buttons are exactly the same things?
I just disassembled this part to show you that these buttons are exactly the same things. They're mechanically connected to each other. Do you see? So when you press one of them, you're activating the same single switch in here. So the only difference between them is related to the time that you use them. For example, when your printer is ready and you press the button, then you get an information page or a demo page. But when your printer is printing something and you want to cancel the job, you press the button. So the only difference is that you use them in different times. And then, do you know what is this?
Of course, this is tray number one, but have you ever used it?
I want to show you how we can use this tray in this condition. I insert a couple of pages into it. Basically, it has space for 10 pages. And this one, tray number two, has space for 150 pages. Now that we have a printer with a couple of trays, there should be a way to choose between them. Or to prefer one over another. For example, if I want to print these pages, I can click on Page Setup. There is an option in here to choose between tray number one or tray number two. But the problem is that it doesn't work. That might be related to the fact that the way that we have used to install the printers on our computers was not a common way of installation. At least, that was not provided by the manufacturer. But still, there are some specific things that you may want to know about tray number one. The first point is that your printer always prefers picking up the papers from tray number one. When it doesn't have any sheets inside it to pick up, then it starts picking up the papers from tray number two. And there is a great application for tray number one. Of course, you have noticed that when you print with this printer, papers get slightly curved at the top. So when you want to print double-sided papers, for the first side, there is no problem.
but for the second side, printer cannot pick up papers exactly. In many cases, it picks up a couple of papers. Think about this condition. You are printing several pages. It picks up the paper number 1, number 2, number 3, and it is printing the second side. And then it picks up a couple of pages at the same time. And you don't know that. Everything gets extremely messy. To prevent it, I have a solution for you. For the second side, at least, all the times use tray number 1. Because it picks up the papers very precisely. The reason is related to the fact that the mechanism of this tray is really simpler in comparison to the tray number 2. If you have any question about this great printer, please tell me in comments. Thanks for watching this video, hope you enjoyed.